Good afternoon and welcome to this interactive session. First, some preliminaries. I am very happy to note that there are more than 125 remote centers which are participating in this FDP. Frankly, this being the first time effort of running such an FDP and a short notice, I had not expected more than 1500 to 2000 participants from across the country. But I am very happy to note that more than 3700 participants have already registered, and I am told that several more may be registering by end of the day today, which is the last date of registration. Of course, by extending the date of registration to 6th, what has happened is that the activities of the FDP in the first week had to be necessarily kept on a low key, which all of you would have noticed. But that is okay, because people have to build up the tempo. I will be communicating this heartwarming participation across the country to the chairman AICT, and I will be requesting him to personally address these participants during one of the face-to-face activity days on the 3 weekends. I also note that 4 centers have expressed some difficulty in arranging the face-to-face sessions on the days mentioned. Frankly, it would normally not be possible, and we would be then requesting the centers to withdraw ordinarily. But this being the first FDP of its kind, we have decided to talk to them independently and find out what best they can do, particularly when the change in dates is being forced due to external circumstances, such as I am told that in Chennai there are elections, and therefore during the election time these activities may not be possible to be held, because the participating college teachers themselves may be away on either duty or on leave. All of you would have read the topics, as I have mentioned in my initial introductory talk and also in a mail that I sent. The idea is not to train people in actual details of technology. That is not the intention. The intention is conveyed very aptly by the title of the FDP: use of ICT for online and blended education. Now, this is going to be a new thing for many participating teachers, and perhaps a new thing for some of the remote centers as well. However, there are several remote centers which have, what is this noise from where? Can somebody go and tell them not to drill for next 1 hour? I am sorry for the disturbance. The studio is supposedly soundproof, but the window on my left, which we have tried to close, is open to external compound where some activity is going on. Now, to begin with, I would like to take a few questions which I see here. The first one is from KLE Institute of Technology, Hubli. I am going over to KLE Institute of Technology, Hubli. Over to you. Sorry. Where?
Hello. Hello. A very good evening, sir. Hello.
Hello. Yeah, please go ahead.
Hello. Sir, your voice is a bit cracking, sir. There is a disturbance coming in.
Voice is cracking. Sound.
Video is also flickering, sir.
Yeah, please repeat.
Sir, now everything is fine, sir.
Is everything is fine, sir?
Yeah. Okay.
Sir, how about it? Today we have received one kind of assignment, sir. Just today it is going to be started. So just need some more information about that, sir. The participants are not yet aware of the assignment, sir. Please give some information about that, sir.
There is no assignment so far given. They just have to do wiki activity as a trial. As I mentioned, during the first week, we have deliberately kept the load low. So they are just required or expected to become accustomed to both the platforms, the Moodle and the IIT Bombay X. Of course, I know that people who are already familiar will feel that their time is being wasted. The objective is to bring every participant on the same level, same basic level, insofar as understanding these platforms is concerned. You will notice that people have been requested to go through the demo course so that they understand the IIT Bombay X functioning better. They have also been told to do a engagement with just trying out writing some wiki page. Incidentally, I forgot to introduce my colleague Jayakrishnan, who is finishing his PhD with Professor Sahanamurthy. So he is handling the part related to both the pedagogical aspects of both the online learning and blended learning. And it is he who has suggested this wiki activity as a trial. Those who are familiar with wiki and familiar with Moodle also will benefit if they actually write down this trial page. Incidentally, if you have read that assignment, which the assignment will actually start from the next week, there will be an IIT Bombay page, hierarchically organized. Below it would be one page for each remote center, and hierarchically organized below each remote center page will be the pages which the participants will be writing. Now that will be the actual exercise, but that exercise will come in the second week and subsequent week. So if participants are a bit apprehensive, let them be apprehensive. It does not matter if they feel a little apprehensive about things. Important thing is they should become familiar with the back end that is going to be used. Okay. Any other observation?
Well, thank you very much, sir.
Righto. Thank you. So let me go over to IPS Academy, Indore.
Hello.
Hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, we have registered on three-way, Moodle, NMEICT and IIT Bombay X. So, during our workshop, we have to log in all three webs every time? All activity will be on this three-web always?
Number one, NMEICT front-end is only the facilitator for registration. Once you are registered, okay, you have nothing to do with NMEICT. Okay, that was just a registration interface. Now, the two back-end platforms that we will be using extensively will be the Moodle platform and the IIT Bombay X platform.
Okay.
Now, we have already advised all participants that they should use the same email ID at both places, the same login ID.
Yes.
Secondly, yes, sir, wherever we believe it is important, we will be giving cross-links. For example, if somebody is in the Moodle, and we expect that person to do an activity such as viewing a video in IIT Bombay X. Apart from saying that please go to IIT Bombay X and view this video, we'll try to put a link there. Similarly, in IIT Bombay X, we'll be duplicating some of the instructions so that if people are visiting IIT Bombay X, they will know what is expected to be done on Moodle. This will not be done for the entire material. I hope you appreciate that. But these are the two platforms, yes, that will be used extensively in this course.
Okay, sir.
Right.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. How many participants have registered at your center?
97, sir.
My God. That brings me to another aspect, and I hope all the other 120 colleagues are listening to this. During the face-to-face, yes, interaction, the pattern that will follow will be some kind of interaction with the concerned faculty members from here with all the participants, but there will be a lot of activity at the remote center controlled by the, yes, workshop coordinator there. Now, we will, okay, expect the laboratory support. There is no special lab like a mechanical engineering lab or electrical engineering lab, but computers will be required to be used by them, and I hope you have the lab facilities, because the numbers are very large.
Sir,
I was looking at these numbers, in fact, and I noticed that there are 7 or 8 institutions which have more than 60 participants, and there is one institution which has 100 participants registered. You also have 90 or something. Now, do you have facilities?
Yes, sir.
Do you have lab or lab or two labs or whatever where all 90 people can be accommodated at one time?
Yes, sir. We have a lab of 120 computers.
Okay.
So, we will accommodate in that.
Good. Thank you. No problem.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Internet facility. And I suppose you have internet facility available.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Yes, there is internet facility in every system, every computer.
Okay, good. Thank you. We go to Anurag.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Anurag Group of Institutions. Over to you.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, we have received, have the one query regarding that submission of Wikidish. We received the mail, recent coordinator and workshop coordinator to submit the institution details. Myself and our remote center coordinator, both of you joined and submitted the details through the remote center coordinator. Can I submit myself also?
No, I did not get you.
Remote institution details we are already submitted through the remote
so
center.
So the answer is yes. You can also be a participant and you can create your own page.
That is not the question. I see. So you want to know that while you have submitted the details of the institution as the coordinator, whether you can also participate as a participant? Is that the question?
Yes, sir.
Of course, it is permitted. We had already clarified it, because this is frankly not a course where you require extensive expertise on part of workshop coordinator, because this is not a subject which is taught regularly, use of ICT in education and so on. And therefore, all that we have stated is two things. Number one, the workshop coordinator could be any senior faculty member who is well versed with use of ICT and who can also and the second point is, we would expect the workshop coordinator for the face-to-face interaction of this workshop more as a facilitator of activities rather than controller of activities. So therefore, we have absolutely no problem. In fact, there are many coordinators who are also participants. In such cases, what we will do is, see, there is a recognition of the participation, which is an independent activity to be done like all other participants. There is also a recognition of an institution for conducting this workshop better. So there, your participation in the role of a coordinator will be judged, whereas as far as the course is FDP is concerned, your participation as a participant will be judged. I hope that is okay.
So one more here. Actually, in our college, we have registered total 160 participants in our college. All departments we have taken the registration participation.
But I don't have here, I don't have 160. What is your
1161.
176.
My God.
Well, I mean,
so
that's a very large number.
Yes, sir.
But are they all total serious about it? Because this might be almost the entire faculty strength of your institution.
Yes, sir. All, only our college students and other college, around 3 to 5 people are registered outside colleges.
Not students. This is for teachers, I hope.
No, sir. Only faculties only.
Okay.
Only faculties.
Do you have lab support for so many people?
Yes, sir. We have. What we are planning, our remote center coordinator and myself, total around 170 participants are registered. Each and every department we allocated for some faculty coordinator representative.
Okay.
So we are organizing like that, sir. We are coordinating individual department. We are arranging coordinator. They're all coordinated to be maintained by myself, sir.
Okay. So the colleagues who are sitting with you, are they likely to be the coordinators of different departments of faculty?
Yes, sir. They are only at the time of starting of the registration. We are arranging one meeting. In the meeting, we discuss around about this workshop and registration details. They are taking care and they are registered. Yesterday, we conducted one meeting. That coordinators also we are informed to do that assignments. What are the assignments given offline? So that they are doing, sir.
Where are you located, Ranga Reddy? Where is it physically located, as in Andhra Pradesh or Telangana? Where
this is. Telangana, sir.
Telangana, okay.
Hyderabad.
Oh,
Hyderabad.
This is near Hyderabad, is it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I think one of these days I would like to visit your institution. This is the first time 176 participants from any institution or group of institutions is coming together. Maybe, as you said, some people are from other institutions, but majority of them are from your place. I am also happy with the arrangement that you are doing, that you will be distributing them in 3 or 4 or 5 different labs or classrooms, and each one will be coordinated by a colleague of yours. Just ensure that this interaction, for example, that is happening today, whatever are the main takeaways from this interaction, please communicate to all these coordinators as well, because as far as I am concerned, I will treat all 5 or 6 of you as coordinators.
Okay, thanks. Definitely.
I mean, equivalent. Of course, you are right in the sense that as far as taking responsibility is concerned, you are the responsible person. So you will.
Last time I was a workshop coordinator of CP2, sir. I know about that.
Okay, okay.
That is
okay,
also, I'm taking care, sir.
Thank you. Thank you
so much. Thank you, sir.
Good. Okay. Let me go to Mahendra Engineering College. This is 1347. Oh, Namakkal. Professor.
Hello.
Kannan Maudgalya's place. Over to you, Namakkal.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, this is the first time we are conducting this program in our campus.
Okay.
Actually, we are having some doubt in the Moodle preparation. Can you just explain with some few words about that Moodle, how to prepare a content for that, so that we will inform to our participants?
So there is some bit of an introduction given, but I'll request JK to explain once again. This will be useful for all other colleagues as well across the country.
Moodle primarily is meant for resource or file submissions and wiki activity. So in the first week, the main activity in Moodle was a wiki submission, where every participant is supposed to create their own individual page and fill it with some introduction about themselves. They have to write a teaching learning mission statement. They have to tell who they are, what domain they teach. So consider this as a introduction thing that somebody, so when I meet you, I say my name, what I'm doing. So it is exactly equivalent to this that you are supposed to do in Moodle. Now, why Wiki? Wiki supports collaborative editing, and the pages are arranged in a hierarchical structure. So at the top, you have a start page, which is completely maintained by the team at IIT Bombay. So we have put up clear instructions that no person is supposed to edit that page except the people at IIT Bombay. Though we are seeing many people, so people are not familiar with it and they start editing this page. This is not what you should do. So in the instructions, we have also provided a PDF which clearly states what you are supposed to do in each page. So in the main start page, we clearly identify what the purpose of wiki is and what are the type of pages inside the wiki.
Now, there is some more clarification required. Yeah. Please understand that this structured exercise will actually begin from the next week.
Yeah.
What has been done in the first week is just to make people familiar with wiki pages. They have been asked to edit a page. So there is no structure which is mandated or maintained during the first week. And that is why you will find people confusing what they should edit, etc., etc. I thought we were very clear that they are expected to create a page and fill it up for themselves. So that is the introduction page they are supposed to write. But because Moodle permits editing of any page by anybody, whenever I have a collaborative forum, there are some people who are tempted to go and edit somebody else's page or write something there. Now that must not happen. Now this discipline we will try to maintain through instructions, and this is what you will have to emphatically state when people come for the first interaction, which we have kept at the end of 2 weeks. So at the end of next week, when they will be coming for face-to-face interaction, this will be one aspect that you will have to emphatically state, that while it is a collaborative forum, primarily you are expected to enter details about your own self in one page, and that also in a hierarchical fashion. So we will give those instructions more clearly and repeat them, but this is the kind of assistance people will require, because people who have never used these kind of forums, they sometimes get confused. Secondly, let me also tell you another purpose. You and I may be quite familiar with filling up forms on the web and so on, but unfortunately there are teacher colleagues amongst us who have never done an interactive activity on a computer related to education. So this is also an opportunity for them. I can always write about myself on a piece of paper. I can always create a Word document or some such document which gives exactly the same details. But I may never have filled up a wiki page interactively on the machine. So forget the wiki page, any interactive page form. So this is an initiation, and therefore do not worry if some of our colleagues make some mistakes in the first week. However, our ambition will be to indicate how they should do it correctly, and we will get it done subsequently with your help when they come for face-to-face interaction. I hope this is all right.
Yes, sir. Thanks for your kind information, sir. And then one more doubt we are having, sir.
Yes.
For the face-to-face interaction, whether any system is required for the participants?
Very
PC?
Much, yes, very much so. I in fact gave that I made that observation while answering the previous question, that the purpose of the face-to-face interaction is twofold. Number one, they'll be doing some group activity. Primarily in the first week, for example, the group activity connected with think, pair, share and such activities, and a flipped classroom. So the participants will be sitting in a class, and the flipped classroom will be directed throughout the week. There will be more details present, but they may have to do something using Moodle or using IIT Bombay X while they are in your place, which means that a lab will have to be arranged. Now if you have very large number of people, as I asked some other colleagues, coordinators from other colleges, they have apparently one group has a lab of 120 people, so they can accommodate all participants. The other college does not have a single lab, but they are going to coordinate between 3 or 4 different labs. And in each lab, they will have a faculty colleague who will be working as a sort of second-in-command coordinator for that particular group of people, with the overall coordination being done by one person. You can adapt any one of these strategies. In the worst case, if you do not have 2 or 3 labs, or if you do not have adequate number of computers, then we do not know how to handle the situation. For this purpose, for the purpose of this FDP, we might consider you giving one machine to 2 people to share. But frankly, that is not the best solution. The best solution is that the participants should have a system to themselves whenever they are doing interactive work on using a computer. But major, this will be required for some part of the time, not all.
The labs are like 2 hours in a day or something.
So for example, 2 days of interaction that we have planned on say 14th, 15th of May, there will be roughly 2 hours of interaction which will require use of computers in front of them. So for 2 hours or 2.5 hours, you will have to arrange for lab. Do you have enough, say 2 or 3 labs where you can accommodate the 67 or 70 people?
Sir, Actually, our strength registered participant is 64. We are having a single lab which is having 6 tests.
Okay. So that is good enough, I think. Yeah. And you have internet connectivity, I hope.
That every system is having an internet connectivity, sir. Very That's good. Not an issue for us.
Very good. Thank you. Any other question?
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Next, I am going over to Ram Meghe Institute of 1193.
Hello, sir. Yes, sir.
Over to you.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
We are having this classroom, but in the classroom there is no facility of lab. We cannot arrange computers here. Labs are in front of the classroom.
That is perfectly fine. You don't have to have computers in the classroom. In fact, we expect the normal classroom to be available for other discussion sessions or for viewing interactive sessions from the faculty. The labs, as JK explained, are required only for 2 hours a day, and we'll have a specific period. And what we'll do is we'll arrange it just after the tea break or some such thing, so that people will have enough time to move from the classroom to the lab. Is that okay?
Okay, sir. We have 69 participants registered.
Oh, I see. Okay. I would like to ask you a question. Out of these 69 participants, what is approximately the number from your own institution and what are the number of outsiders?
Outsiders are three members are there, outsiders.
Okay.
So they are registered.
Majority of the people are from your own institution.
Yes, sir.
Which is perfectly fine.
Other people are busy.
Yeah. No. I will tell you the question that I have. It is not, I am not concerned with so many people, but are you very sure that all the large number of participants from your own college will be serious about this course and will participate actively?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. They are really serious. Other are busy in university examinations.
Oh,
they were also interested.
Oh, I see.
But due to examinations, they could not register.
Fair enough. It's not a problem. So we look forward to your wider participation. Thank you. Remote center
Thank
number
you,
1006. NIT Trichy. Ah. Over to you, NIT Trichy, and welcome.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
My name is Dr. Kannabiran, workshop coordinator, and
Dr. Suresh, center coordinator.
Sir, we have a couple of points. The first one is about the elections that are happening in Tamil Nadu, and so we don't require any alternate arrangements, but we are only expecting that maybe the attendance will be poor on that weekend, that is 13-14.
Ours is 13-14 or 14-15.
14-15.
Yeah. In fact, there are two centers in Chennai who have actually requested for a change of date, which appears very difficult at this stage. We are considering what is to be done, and I will come up with some answer. I thought the elections in that phase were only in Chennai, but I didn't know Trichy also has elections around the same time.
Yeah. It's state of Tamil Nadu on a single day, on 16th.
So on 17th are the elections, isn't it? I don't know when are the elections.
Sir, 16th.
Oh, 16th.
Kerala and Tamil Nadu are.
Oh, I see. But why do you think 14th, 15th the attendance will be thinner? Because will they have election duty or something?
No. We don't have election duty issues, but generally people avoid traveling because a lot of campaigning and all that happening. People avoid traveling those days.
Oh, I see.
Yes, sir. Many of these people are traveling. Our college is located about 20 kilometers away from the city, and they need to travel. I mean, I'm maybe 50-60% of the people will attend.
Okay. it's a dilemma because the two centers in Chennai have clearly stated that they would prefer some alternate days. I'll tell you our problem.
Yes, sir.
Our problem is that the faculty colleagues, Prasanna Murthy and JK are going to be personally present on 14-15. Now, what we were thinking tentatively was as follows. As you know, all these interactions are recorded. So, we would record their own observations and we'll record question answers that are asked. And these recorded material, we'll make it available for downloading by rendering it very quickly. Now, one suggestion is that immediately following the elections, the 16th are the elections. So, if it is okay with you, then we could plan 17th, 18th or 18th, 19th as 2 days of interaction, where we could request participants to hold the interactive session on those 2 days. But you will have to use the pre-recorded material that has been given. I will request either Sahana Murthy or JK, if possible, to be available for some time to do any hands-on question answering if possible. I may also be present for some time. Now, since there are a large number of such requests, I did not realize that, I thought there were only 4 centers, but it appears that most centers in Tamil Nadu and Kerala may have this problem. Kerala also has the same election. I see. So, what do you suggest? One possibility is we stick to these dates and the participants who are unable to come on 14, 15 for whatever reason, they should do these exercises on their own by viewing the recorded version of interaction on 14, 15, which they can do on 17, 18 themselves. And if they need any clarification, with prior appointment on a single day for a few hours, they could come to you and clarify some of the things which they want. How do you like the idea?
That is Yeah, it is perfectly all right, sir. Whoever is able to attend 14-15 will attend.
Fine.
Whoever misses, use this recorded material.
Right.
Go through it. Right. Any questions, they will come back to the coordinator and get it clarified.
Good.
The other point is, there was one participant who is presently in Dubai and she is not having her ID. She has sent her passport, I think, as ID. But she has sent a letter from the college nominating her, permitting her for the workshop. I'm not sure whether you want to permit that lady also.
I see. But that person will not be able to come for any interaction at all over the entire period.
She is coming back for the election. She is coming back for the election. 17th, she will be back.
So, what is the problem? I did not understand. If coming back,
we need the institute ID card. And the permission letter to register.
Oh, Mahendra is
she
there.
She is not having her institute ID card now.
I see. The person does not have institute ID card and the permission letter. Mm. The person is coming back, all right. Yes. Can you tell me the name of the person?
Hemalata, Dr. Hemalata.
Dr.
Hemalata.
Hemalata. So, I am requesting my colleague, the manager from workshop team, Mr. Mahendra Parmar, to take note of this and certify, clear the registration of Dr. Hemalata. As a special case, this can be uploaded later. Thank you so much for this input. We will not let her miss
the provision. Yeah. One more point is the provision to create a group among our participants so that we can communicate ourselves?
No. Come again?
Is there a provision in the system to form a group of all the 27 participants of our center?
Yeah. In fact, there will be multiple groups formed during the process and we'll be using Moodle extensively. So, there will be a group formed, one group which will be all participants from your remote center. That will be one group.
Okay.
So, that group can communicate with each other. Correct. So, that you can write to that group and of course, you will be made a member of that group and you can communicate with them. Second, there could be groups which are formed for the purpose of team assignments, which they will be doing later.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
So, one second, who is taking the responsibility of forming groups per remote center? So far, we have not done that. Sorry?
I didn't get your question, sir. Basically, there are 27 participants. We wanted a group so that we can communicate about schedules or any informal discussions.
Yes.
That's what we want, a provision to form a group. If it is there, we are okay with it.
No, they cannot do that because they do not have teacher access. They cannot form groups.
So they have a domain-based grouping, which is their survey that is happening in the next, in the coming.
Oh, week. I see. Okay, I was not aware of this. Jaikrishnan tells me, why don't you explain?
Yes, you can form internal groups within your college. That is one aspect. I think a previous college had already mentioned that they have mini groups and they have group coordinators. Another aspect of it is that since there are multiple domains, there will be a domain-based grouping for many of the activities. Since activity review, etc., requires some amount of domain expertise.
Like mechanical engineering, civil engineering, etc.
Electrical and allied and all those things. Right. A survey question will be put up in Moodle in the coming week. People have to select their domain and they will be automatically put into that group within Moodle itself. So there is a domain-based grouping in the Moodle and all the activities will happen.
No, but you are answering a different question altogether. What he wants to know is a very simple thing. Is there an automatic formation of a group of all faculty participants who belong to one remote center?
Yes, it is already there in the Moodle itself. By default, all of you are part of one group. And
but it is not visible to them. Is it visible to them?
There is a provision without a message. For example,
has that provision been exercised?
Yes.
Okay, what JK tells me is that this grouping has already been done. It is an implicit grouping. So, whenever people enroll for the FDP and they select a remote center, and when they are admitted, they automatically belong to a group of that remote center. Now, only thing is the remote center coordinators are not familiar with this fact.
Okay.
So, what I will do is give us this weekend. We'll be preparing a special email to all the coordinators saying that you actually are part of the group of all participants of that particular remote center, and this is the mechanism by which you can communicate only with your group members.
Yes.
Good enough.
Thank you very much for this. Was a very important observation that you made. It will help everybody. Thank you so much. I forgot Thank your name.
Annabiran. Professor Kannabiran.
Okay. Thank you so much.
People who are attending on 17th and 18th, workshop coordinator has to manually check that they are there and they are doing the activity.
Yeah. I will once again repeat the discussion that we had on the dates, and this is therefore an answer to all remote centers. We will not change the dates of interaction. The dates of interaction shall remain what they are. There could be some centers where, as NIT Trichy coordinator said, some people may not be able to come. There could be some centers where nobody may come. However, the dates of interaction are firm and they will remain as they are. What we will do instead is that we will record the entire interaction that happens between IIT Bombay and all remote centers, and this recording will be quickly rendered and made available within 48 hours on, let's say, IIT Bombay X as videos or whatever it is. And we will intimate all participants of these remote centers where they are not able to conduct, in fact, we'll send a general circular. Now, those participants who are unable to attend the face-to-face interaction on those days are expected to go through that interaction and do the activities on their own. There will be one major problem, that some of the activities are expected to be done in groups, and therefore the only way it is possible is that these participants who miss the face-to-face interaction form their own groups. say 4 people, 5 people, 8 people, whatever, try to identify where they are from, etc., form their own groups and spend 1, 2, 3 hours, whatever is required, to do that group activity together. They will have to do it on their own by looking at the videos of these interactions and such thing that happen there. Further, as our friend suggested, they should contact the workshop coordinator for any individual clarification or group clarification by seeking a date, and each workshop coordinator is requested that for such people who unfortunately have to miss these days for whatever valid reason, they will allocate a particular day, say a few hours, where they will be available for explaining things to them on what happened in the face-to-face interaction. Is that okay?
No.
Is this arrangement all right? No, you're.
But for the instance, you are not going to tell the participant that issues. As of now, we will tell them there are that everybody should attend. So, we will not give the option to them anyway.
Right. Good point. I think you are a good teacher. You can anticipate how students will react. So, thank you for making that suggestion. We will not make any announcement. So, this is for the benefit of all coordinators who are attending this workshop, as far as this FDP. As far as the FDP is concerned, the dates are sacrosanct. We will see if some people miss those dates, then what is to be done? We will take a call roughly on the lines that we have discussed, but will not announce it upfront. So, as of now, the interaction days are exactly as they have been announced. They will remain same. We will know how many people are not able to attend, etc., on that day, and then we will issue appropriate instructions for any compensation if possible. But he is very right, if I pre-announce it, probably a large number of people will even take a holiday, although there is no election or anything there. We will not do that.
Correct.
Yes. Thank you. We now go to Junagadh, Noble Group Institute of Engineering.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, this is Mohit, workshop coordinator. Just I would like to take one question regarding the participant.
Yes.
We are registering 42 participants.
Okay.
And in that participant, 9 to 10 participants are from outside of our institute. So, there is one question, except the workshop date, they can do their activity at own place or they have to come here?
No, they don't have to come here. In fact, the whole idea of converting the FDP into primarily an online kind of activity for a large percentage of work is to permit all our individual teacher colleagues to work from wherever they want to work. As a matter of fact, only group activity that will happen will be during the days, is planned during the days of face-to-face interaction on the 3 weekends. This applies to even teachers from your own institution. They can also work at their own pace, at their own choice. Of course, they might find it convenient to come to the office and do the work because they will probably get access to a good system, good internet connection, etc., etc. But frankly, if I have to view some video lecture at my home, I can do so. I will be issuing a mail, again an instruction, where I will be requesting all participants to maintain a diary. You see, one problem is Indians do not traditionally write diaries. I don't expect them to write personal diaries. But I expect them to write professional diaries for this FDP, whatever activity they are doing. This they will be required to maintain in the soft copy form, and they will have to submit this diary. This diary will not be visible to others, but they will have to submit it at an assignment, as an assignment which we will be able to scrutinize. Now, I might say, for example, in my diary that I viewed this session which Jai Krishnan had recorded, let us say on Sunday night from 11 o'clock to 11:30. That is perfectly fine. What they may not know is that we have a big data analytics group which captures all the event logs on IIT Bombay X platform. So, we will be able to validate a very large number of such diary entries whether they are accurate or not. So, we will expect people to write these diaries, and this way we will be able to know at the end what is the average time that people had to spend actually for successfully completing this course. Sorry for extending the answer, but again to come back to your question, there is absolutely no need for participants either from outside your college or even from your own college to physically come to your college during the week to do these activities. If they do want to come and work, and if you can provide them facilities, well and good. Because with all said and done, group of 3 or 4 faculty members working together, interacting, discussing, always enhances the knowledge beyond what an individual can do. But that's their choice.
Okay, sir. And sir, is there any other software requirement in laboratory session?
No, absolutely nothing. We will be using Moodle and IIT Bombay X for this particular interactive session that we are planning. We will be exposing the participants to a variety of other pieces of software for which we will give them instructions. Okay. We will use only open source software. But if the teachers are interested and if some of the assignments they want to do involves that software, they can download it, install it and use it. That will be part of the activity. The institution does not have to provide for anything special.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. That's it from our side.
Thank you. Let me go over to D.Y. Patil, College of Engineering.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening, Jai Krishnan.
Please go ahead.
Sir, to share with you, we at our institute, we always are a part of this number of additional things for teaching and learning purpose. I think once Jai Krishnan was at our institute, it was some 4 years back, if I'm not wrong. He had been one of the resource person for one of our such workshop, and we stress on to share with you a few of the earlier workshops which we had under this MMEICT, that is pedagogy, technical communication. We do have a good number of participants also, not from only our institute, but our adjacent colleges in this vicinity also, sir. And to share with that, we just not close this with the end of the workshop, but we keep a track of the participants, obviously at our institute. And to share with us, this has helped us to gain a good name for our institute in this field of teaching learning, sir. This is long back, we always take a feedback. It's somewhere monthly we do have learners forum wherein teachers come together and share. To say a few, almost 7 or 8 teachers practice this wikis because it was a part in pedagogy workshop. So that is, yes sir, we are going on with it, and that is how really we feel that it's very fruitful to have such workshops.
Well, thank you so much, and I'm delighted to hear that you have affiliated activities going on, particularly tracking what the other teachers do after the workshop is an important thing. There is an element in this FDP which is about building and nurturing collaborative communities. I'll be very happy if you could write down a small note on how you have tried to build and nurture this small community. I'd be very happy to put it up as a part of this course material for other centers and other colleges to actually emulate. It's a very good example.
Yes, sure, sir. Sir, 2 more things I would just like to highlight. Yeah. I don't know, might be this is what I have thought and as a suggestion, sir. I really feel practicing with this blend of interactions for learning. Somewhere, although we do have experience that we keep a track of teachers, but to keep it, I really feel might be, since this workshop is going to take place till August, our session will start somewhere in June, July. I expect that you should ask each participant to say that how this reaches to the students, finally to the class, and there should be some steps to be prepared by each participant. That will be the real-time implementation by the teacher, which will surely help the teacher to have a practical view of it in its own sessions later on.
Okay. It's a very good point, and it has come up for internal discussion many times. So let me tell you the larger vision. The larger vision is that the AICT chairman, Professor Sahasrabuddhe, wants me to conduct this kind of FDP for all 5 lakh teachers of all college, professional colleges of the country in the next 3 years. Now, that's a humongous task. He would like every teacher from every professional institution to be aware of how to most effectively use technology. And whatever you are saying, both about pedagogy and about actually using it in the classroom, are vital ingredients of implementing this program. Now, this is the first of the FDPs that we are conducting. We wanted to conduct it as soon as possible, and the only time available was summer months, when practically the colleges can participate as remote centers and people can spend some time. But you are correct. In real life, it is much better if some aspects of this FDP are actually implemented when the teachers are actually teaching. Now, you will notice that there is a team activity here as a part of this FDP, which people have to undertake in teams and submit that team assignment within 4 weeks of completion of the face-to-face, online interaction. So that means in the month of July and part of the month of August, that is when they will be submitting this assignment. And one suggestion that we will be making to the participating teachers is that if they could decide on a team activity which involves them to design a portion of some material or some topic which they can actually experiment as a flipped classroom in their own college with their own students in the subject that they teach. That is the reason why we have chosen to make domain specific teams, so that those teachers can come together on a specific domain or a course. Now, it may not work in all cases, because there may be teachers belonging to the same domain but teaching different courses in their places. The point being made is that even if one of the team members says, okay, I will experiment in my college in Amravati, let us say, then the other 3 team members can actually go there on that day of interaction to that Amravati college and see how the flipped classroom works when that particular faculty member engages it. These are the activities that we have in mind. Going forward, when we will refine this FDP further and we will run it for a larger number of people, we will require a much larger number of associate faculty members. IIT Bombay alone cannot run it. So you will notice that in my announcement itself, I have stated that we will not only be honoring 200 top performing teachers, for which we have yet to define the exact criteria, etc., but we will be also be requesting them whether they are interested in participating in future FDPs as associate faculty. And obviously, who are the people who are most appropriate for being associate faculty? Well, these will be the people who either in their team assignments or independently have actually used part of this pedagogy in their own classroom, and they are willing to guide and assist other colleagues in doing exactly the same thing. So I have that in mind. This is the first of the workshop, but thank you for this suggestion. This we already had factored in. So the team assignments, when they will be explained, we'll be doing that. So you mentioned 2 important things. One is the possibility of the team assignments of this FDP itself being part practicing with the students. The second is following up with the teachers after the workshop in terms of building a small community and nurturing that community with some discussion. That is, both of these are explicit parts of this FDP. So thank you so much for your observations.
Sir. Yes, thank you, sir. And I would really like to associate with this if I could.
Good, good. I'll keep that in mind. Mahindra,
yeah.
Note her credentials. She is already hired for the next workshop.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So, University BDT College of Engineering. Where is this?
Good evening, sir.
Ah, good evening. Is it Davangere?
Sir, yeah, Davangere, sir.
Ah, okay.
It's Karnataka.
Yeah, yeah. How are you?
Fine, sir. Sir, is it necessary to provide computers or PCs in face-to-face interaction, during face-to-face interaction?
Not for the entire day, as I explained to earlier questions. This will have to be provided.
Yeah, we have labs in next our room, we have lab, but in this setup room, we don't have
PCs. No. Let me clarify again. Please do not change your classroom environment. Classrooms are classrooms, and they will be used for interactive sessions and even for group work, such as think, pair, share activities, etc. But during the 2 days of face-to-face interaction, there will be 1 or 2 hours when the participants will be required to access the computers, for which they will move to the lab.
Yeah.
So as long as you have a lab, that is good enough. Yeah.
We have such facilities.
Right.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yashwantrao Chavan, College of Engineering. Over to you.
1155. Hello.
Yeah, hello. Over to you. You have any question, please raise.
Hello.
Hello, we can hear you. Please go ahead.
Yes. Good afternoon, sir. Well, I would like to know, is there any specific software or hardware required during the face-to-face interaction?
No, absolutely not. As long as you have PCs connected to internet and you have browsers working, that's all will be required. As I mentioned in answer to some other question earlier, if there are participants who wish to experiment with some software, they will be expected to download, install it on their own machines and experiment with that. Now, such a software, for example, for preparing spoken tutorials, when we discuss spoken tutorials, or for experimenting with Moodle. After all, Moodle is open source and Moodle is accessible from the net, so people can practice whatever they need to do and use our Moodle. But suppose some teachers wish to download Moodle, install it and start using it as a part of the activity, they are most welcome to do that. But at the remote center, you are not required to provide any specific additional facility. That is not required.
Okay. Sir, one more thing. How the grading should be evaluated? At the remote center or at the IIT Bombay? The submission of the assignment, how it is graded?
Grading policy. So, you will notice that grading policy has not been announced yet. We are still figuring that out. First of all, when you have 4,000 participants, it is not possible for any small group at IIT Bombay or anywhere else to evaluate and do the proper assessment of all submissions. Particularly, the submissions are in the form of open educational resources, which could be fairly large. We propose to use peer assessment as one of the important aspects of the assessment. The peer assessment process itself will be first explained properly to people and we will be implementing that. As far as the remote centers are concerned, we would expect some kind of qualitative judgment on the assignments that have been submitted by the teams when they do a final submission. We will be doing the assessment of the team assignments later ourselves, but we would expect some support from the remote centers. And it will be a very simple qualitative assessment, such as whether, like, you should be able to cursorily look at a team assignment submitted by a team of people working in your remote center and should be able to classify it as A, B and C. So, C, which is not acceptable, B, which is okay, and A, which is excellent. So you don't have to give detailed marks, 73.5 out of 100 or some such thing. That is not expected. We would also not be indulging in that. But we would like to identify teams which do some extraordinary work or effort, and we would like to identify teams which do less than acceptable work, because the certificate will be dependent on these. So that's the only direct assistance that we would expect from the remote centers as far as this FDP is concerned. Of course, if the remote center so wishes to further extend the activities, as the lady was from Dr. D.Y. Patil was saying, we will be towards the end of this FDP, we will be setting up a mechanism for building and nurturing collaborative communities. And one suggestion which I will be making towards the end of the course is that those 30, 40, 50, 60 participants from your remote center who have spent 3 weekends together could form the kernel of the first collaborative community centered around your remote center itself. Now it is up to them and you together to decide how to take this small collaborative community further for future interaction, if any. But that is not part of the FDP. That will be just a suggestion that we will be making. Is that okay? The delay. Central University of Rajasthan.
Hello?
Yeah, hello. Hello.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, we are from Central University of Rajasthan.
Yes, yes. Welcome.
This is our fourth workshop, sir. Previously, we have conducted 3 workshops.
I see.
Sir, we are in this workshop now. When compared to last workshops, this is very participants are feeling it is too lengthy, sir. 1 month and 3 phases are there. If it would be 2 weeks, then it would be fine for the participants.
Yes,
this is our remark.
No, that is correct. But AICT wanted us to run a 4-week FDP, and okay, as you will notice from our what should I say, the material that we have put up in the announcement, we do not expect a teacher working alone at his or her home or office during the week to spend more than 6 to 8 hours per week on this FDP. And therefore, we had to necessarily convert one working day into one physical week or duration week. And that is why you will notice that if we have 10 days, we have a total requirement of conducting a 4-week FDP, out of which we have 2 weeks of work which is to be done online. That translates into 10 working days, which means 10 weeks. There has to be 1 week of face-to-face interaction, which we have translated into 3 weekends. And you will notice that we have not put those at the end of 10 weeks, but we have put them interspersed with these 10 weeks itself. So that during the weeks of those interaction, people will also have to do some online activity and come face to face. Finally, when they have to do a teamwork, we are saying 4 weeks are allocated. The actual work required is 4 days equivalent work. Now, it is perfectly possible for a team at your end, when the team is formed, and we will expect team formation to start from the first interaction itself, we would expect teams to be frozen at the end of second interaction. Nothing prevents them from taking up the assignment, and when they meet for the third interaction with you, those small teams sit together, discuss exactly what they wish to do. And let us say a particular team of 4 teachers may decide that this interaction is ending on Saturday and Sunday, last interaction. After that, let us meet for 4 days in my college or your college and finish off the entire engagement and assignment. They are most welcome to submit the team assignment much earlier. They don't have to wait for end of the 4 weeks. But technically, technically the duration of the FDP has to match with the minimum number of hours that the participants must spend. I hope you will agree with that.
Okay.
So we will be clarifying this possibility to participants as we proceed ahead in the course. Thank you. we have Vishwakarma Institute of, there is no video from Vishwakarma. So we'll go to Dronacharya College of Engineering. Yes. Over to
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah, I can hear you. Please go ahead.
Okay. So at Dronacharya College of Engineering, Greater Noida, we have around 30 participants for this workshop. And I am damn sure that the use of ICT in education for online and blended learning will be very helpful to my participants of engineering as well as from other departments. I have one question, like all the submission will be through Moodle only, no, sir?
Yes and no. The assignments requiring large files to be submitted, they will be submitted on Moodle. But the quizzes, the online multiple choice quizzes, which participants have to attempt at their own pace, at their own time, before the deadline, those will be conducted on IIT Bombay X. So the multiple choice quizzes will be conducted.
And the assignment?
Yeah, please go ahead.
So the assignment would be individual or all would be the group activity?
It is actually a mix of both.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you. RVRJ College of Engineering.
Evening,
this is Chobis Pargana, West Bengal. Over to you.
This is Professor Chandrasekhar, Remote Center Coordinator. Sir, I am happy to inform that 67 students got registered for this course.
Guntur.
And participants, sorry. 67 participants registered for this course. Out of 67, 22 from outside institutions and 45 from our institution. And we had restriction from various departments of our college. We have taken only the 5 maximum participants from each department. And one more thing I would like to highlight that I don't know that whether this information can be shared with you or not. We are not collecting the 1,000 rupees of fee from the participants, sir, because we have taken the permission from our management. They have immediately accepted that we don't need to collect the 1,000 rupees from the participants. And without collecting an amount, we provide all the facilities to the participants, know that lunch, accommodation, and snacks, whatever required. So, just I wanted to keep this information in front of you, sir.
No,
and regarding that participants, sir, tell me, sir.
Yeah, please go ahead. I will make an observation later, but it's a good thing that you are doing.
22 participants are coming from outstation, sir, because they have to travel 3 times for all the 3 spells of face-to-face interact sessions, and they can use that money for their travel purpose. That is the intention behind that. And moreover, our institution is a non-profit based institute, sir. Always our management people are kind enough to do maximum extent of service, sir. And the rest of things, sir, regarding that participants advantage point of view, and you have given some deadline for the first task, that is on 8th of this month, and most of the participants are new for this particular kind of courses, sir, even though it is a faculty development program. And when they attend face-to-face interaction on 14th, 15th, we can create more awareness for them in order to submit the assignments and how to give the solutions for all our exercises. And for the first time, I request you that instead of deadline on 8th, if possible, please keep the deadline on 2nd week, that is on 15th, sir, for only for the first spell. That is my request, sir, if possible.
Okay. Good point that you made.
Most of the participants, they don't have aware of it.
Yeah, that's okay. So let me respond to both observations that you have made. First of all, my compliments to your college, which is willing to bear the expenses for conducting the face-to-face sessions. I hope all remote centers and all institutions come forward to that. because that will save money from the teachers. But I would mention two things in this context, not belittling what you have done. What your college has done is excellent and I appreciate that. But let us understand one thing, in this world there is no free lunch. There is a cost for doing everything. Out of enthusiasm and goodwill, I will be willing to do a good deed like this once, maybe twice, maybe three times. But suppose I expect your college to conduct such face-to-face sessions on every weekend for 50 people, then it may not be possible for the college to continue to provide the resources which are required. Please understand that not only the enthusiastic faculty members like you, but technical staff will have to be present there to arrange the AVU interaction. There will have to be an attendant who will have to open the room and close the room in the evening. Now, these are people who are just doing their duties. And without some recognition, some payment of honorarium, why would these people continue to work day in and day out continuously? That is the reason why I had built a provision of some payment of honorarium. It is notional. We are not paying salaries or anything to people. So, sustenance on the long term becomes difficult. And as I mentioned to other coordinator's question earlier, we propose to conduct this FDP for all 5 lakh teachers to be benefited in the country who teach in professional colleges. Not just engineering colleges, but architecture, pharmacy, management, all of these. And eventually the ministry wants to consider whether similar training programs can be arranged for teachers of 36,000 other colleges and then finally teachers of all high schools. Because the use of ICT is going to help us to improve our productivity. Therefore, there has to be some formal mechanism. Second point I will make is, when we say teachers should not have to pay, I appreciate that point. But I'll go one step further. Suppose I am a teacher in one college and I am attending this FDP. Doesn't my college also benefit from the learning that I do? When I teach in my own college, don't my students benefit? Shouldn't my college then support my participation in this FDP? In fact, by paying the remote center 1,000 rupees or reimbursing that expenditure, plus reimbursing that travel expenditure, should that not be done by the college? Because the college is likely to benefit from my services in future years. So, this is another thought I would like to put forward. I will be addressing the principals and the chairman of various engineering colleges through a communication later after the completion of this FDP. I mentioned this in the VOSA conference recently, that shouldn't our colleges consider it a part of incentivization of their faculty by actually sponsoring them and meeting these small expenses to participate in such thing. So, as I said, what you are doing is extremely good. My compliments to you and your institution. And since this is the first FDP of its kind, I really appreciate that you are not putting a charge to the participating teachers, thereby encouraging them to come forward with more freedom.
One more doubt, sir, regarding the participants. Earlier we have conducted one FDP on introduction to structural engineering, civil engineering.
Yes.
For civil engineering faculty members. And there we have formed one team, like teaching assistants, give assistance for the workshop coordinator.
Right.
And there is a AV coordinator. Anyhow, he is giving service for now also, that AV coordinator.
Right.
And of course, teaching assistants are required in order to evaluate the assignments that will be submitted by the participants. This time also, can we form a group, right? Otherwise, assignment will be evaluated by IIT Bombay or by the workshop coordinator, sir?
No, the assignments will be assessed either through peer review process or there will be multiple choice questions which will be assessed automatically. So, there is no assessment that is required to be done at the remote center level. Only for the team assignments, which are submitted by the teams attending at your remote center, we would expect a very quick qualitative assessment of all the team submissions, only dividing them into 3 categories, A, B and C. So, no detailed assessment is required. Besides, the submissions will be in their own respective domains. So you cannot find a teaching assistant who can assess, let us say, an open educational resource submitted in civil engineering and also an open educational resource submitted in communication technology. It will not be possible because the teachers who will be attending will be from disparate domains. That is why we don't see any need for teaching assistants. But we will be forming, we will be forming sectoral communities starting with this FDP, which will expand in numbers over the coming months and years. And we will be using resources from these sectoral communities to do assessment of team submissions in future FDPs. Okay. I have yet to answer the first question that you asked, the submission date. First of all, the submission date will not be 8th, although that is what we had announced. Jayakrishnan and I have discussed this, and we will be keeping the submission date as 10th afternoon, so that they have Monday and Tuesday, so that they are not at the remote center, but they can consult their colleague teachers in the college if they have any problem. Second, the assignment for the first week is not a graded quiz or anything. These are all entry level surveys which collect information about the participants and their thoughts. And the entry level surveys must be completed at the entry point. There is no point in their writing answers to it after they have participated for 2 weeks in the course. So we will change the submission date from 8th May to 10th May, but we will insist that people submit. These are all online surveys and they can access Moodle from wherever they want and they can finish that. All right.
Sir, last point from my side.
Yeah.
And during earlier FDP, there are 4 sessions per day from 9 o'clock to 5 o'clock.
Yes.
And each session will be handled by expert from IIT Bombay.
Yes.
And the session was conducted in this manner, like there will be some live session for half an hour or 45 minutes, whatever it may be, that is followed by interaction with the participants now. Can we expect that the future sessions also in the same way, all the 6 days?
Not necessarily all the 6 days. In fact, there will be major activities in the remote center coordinated entirely by you. The think, pair, share activity will have to be done by all participants, for example, in your remote center, entirely coordinated by you. The faculty team will tell you what exactly is the activity to be done, how it is to be conducted, but it has to be conducted locally, and that will typically be the afternoon session, which will be in a classroom. Also, it might be required that the participants should assemble in a lab where they have computers such as you have them here for about 2 hours when they will be working on the computers.
Thank you very much for answering my doubts. And our coordinator has one more question with him, right, please?
Yeah, sure.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Dr. Sri Nagesh, workshop coordinator for this program. Obviously, you have told that the role of workshop coordinator is not controller but facilitator. Can you quickly tell in 2 or 3 points what are the roles of the facilitator and workshop coordinator?
So, first of all, the workshop coordinator has to go through the material that needs to be discussed during the face-to-face session ahead of time. So, what we'll be doing is either through a separate mail, we'll be sending an instruction to all workshop coordinators, which will be copied to RC coordinators also, saying how you should prepare for conducting the face-to-face session in your remote center. Secondly, all participants will also be informed ahead of time what exactly they are expected to do when they come for face-to-face session. And those activities will have to be done. Now, when you do those activities, they are largely self-driven activities or group-driven activities. All that you have to ensure is that appropriate groups are formed, that people in a group sit close to each other, that they complete their work. Sometimes what happens is in that think, pair, share method, the time that is taken by a particular group may be slightly longer than other time. Now, simple things like doing time management, you know, requesting groups, jaldi khatam karo kind of thing. So, that is the role of a facilitator. You are like a senior colleague in that group, which is trying to ensure that things are conducted exactly in the manner in which they are expected to be conducted. That's all.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Right.